For all of us, but particularly I think for parents, it's hard to think of anything that matters more to us than the health of our family, especially our children. Since we've been in office, we've made health a priority. But as with most government spending, the dollar amount is just one measure of what we do. Other measures matter too. For example, smoking rates are coming down, immunisation rates are going up, and more New Zealanders are getting the operations they need. What matters to most of us is whether we and our family members can get high quality, affordable health care in a timely manner. On each of those tests, we're doing better for lots of people. 96% of children under 6, or over 350,000 kids, are now able to visit the doctor during the day and after hours for free. This is due to policies we've introduced since we came into office in 2008. In that same period, we've seen more doctors and nurses employed too. There are 1,000 extra doctors and 2,000 extra nurses permanently employed at district health boards today compared to 2008. They contribute to an improvement in healthcare with shorter waiting times, more surgical procedures and better preventative measures. We've also got some specific health targets in our Better Public Services program. One is to reduce the incidence of rheumatic fever by two-thirds by June 2017. Rheumatic fever primarily affects Maori and Pacific kids. It generally follows a strep throat infection. It's preventable, but it can have very serious lifelong consequences if it's not treated early. And it's better, of course, not to get it at all. The value of publicly setting specific targets is that you then really focus on meeting them. So $24 million has already been allocated through previous budgets, with most of it going to throat swabbing services in schools in high-risk areas. The Minister of Health, Tony Ryle, and the Associate Minister, Tariana Turia, have announced another $21 million to extend the program to catch more kids. It's too soon to definitely identify a downward trend for rheumatic fever, but the provisional analysis is hopeful. Healthier homes are also part of the story, and we're working on that too. It's worth it for the sake of our kids.